Every game but one has been played for week 2, and there are some major takeaways just a few games into the NFL season. The NFL season, as we know, is a marathon and not a sprint, but some teams are making huge strides in directions they want to go, and others are heading south and not looking good to say the least. The 2020 season with no preseason is not surprisingly the year of the injury, as there were countless stars that went down on Sunday afternoon. Nick Bosa, Saquon Barkley, Drew Lock, Anthony Barr, and countless others were injured today, and that is one of the biggest takeaways of the second week of the year. We need the preseason more than people realize, and this season has already shown that. Before we dive into takeaways from NFL teams rather than news around the league, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as all support is very much appreciated. Now let's begin. The takeaways, like every week, are in no particular order, and the first one we will discuss is the Los Angeles Rams are legit. Admittedly, I wasn't too big on them heading into the year, and through 2 weeks they have proved me wrong. They beat the Cowboys on the opening Sunday night of the year, and they went into Philly on Sunday and won by 3 scores. They play in Buffalo next week, which should be a very good game, as Jalen Ramsey going against Stephon Diggs for 4 quarters will be must-see football. Jared Goff threw for over 260 yards and 3 touchdowns on Sunday, and LA nearly rushed for 200 yards, led by Daryl Henderson and Malcolm Brown. Goff spread the ball around equally on Sunday, and when they do that, they are a very hard team to beat. They will need to keep the wins up in order to keep pace in that division, as we know the NFC West will be very competitive all year long. They are officially back, and there's no reason that they can't start out 4-1 or 5-0, as their next 3 games are at Buffalo, home against the Giants, and at the football team. The Buffalo game will be very difficult to win, but if they can pull that off, then the sky truly is the limit for this team. 2 games is obviously a small sample size, but through 2 games, Jared Goff is on pace for a career high in passer rating and a career high in completion percentage. He needed to step up with the losses of Todd Gurley and Brandon Cooks this offseason, and through 2 weeks, he has. The Rams can cause serious problems for teams in 2020. And the next takeaway is the AFC runs through Baltimore. Through 2 games, this team has won by multiple scores in both contests, and has put up 71 points to their opponent's 22. They have given up the least amount of points in the NFL, and they are top 3 in points scored. Now, we all thought the AFC ran through Baltimore last year, and it did, don't get me wrong. They just lost to a Tennessee team that played a great game in the AFC divisional round of the playoffs. Baltimore more than learned their lesson, and they very well could be in the midst of a revenge tour against the entire NFL. Everyone is amped to watch their Week 3 Monday night game, which of course brings the Kansas City Chiefs into M&T Bank Stadium. Lamar is 21-3 as an NFL starter, with 2 of those 3 losses coming against the Chiefs. There are 2 things the Ravens will want to take care of in the 2020 season, and this is certainly one of them. Lamar wants to prove he can beat Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs, as he has beat every other team he has played but them so far. The only other loss he has is to Cleveland, which he has beat multiple times since. Anyways, the other task they will want to accomplish is winning a playoff game, and ultimately, the Super Bowl. That is of course a few months from now, but treating every week like a championship game like they do will translate to wins over the course of time. The Ravens' defense is playing lights out. Their offense is, well, I don't have to tell you guys how good their offense is, and they are, as of now, the best team in football. The AFC runs through Baltimore, and they are on a mission to prove the critics wrong. And the next takeaway is the NFC could very well run through Green Bay. The Packers through 2 weeks have put up 85 points against divisional opponents, and as of now, Aaron Rodgers is on pace for 42 touchdowns and 0 interceptions. He has looked like the old Aaron Rodgers, and as we have discussed before, the fire lit beneath him definitely wasn't burnt out prior to this year, as we have clearly seen that so far, but the selection of Jordan Love certainly was like lighting another match to it. Not only is Rodgers looking elite again, but the run game the last 2 years has been better than what he's had at any point in his NFL career. Aaron Jones rushed for over 160 yards and 2 touchdowns against the Lions and looked like a great NFL running back. Notice I said great NFL running back and not top 5 or 10, because that running back position is absolutely generational at this point with all the talent we have across the league. Anyways, they play at New Orleans next week, which will certainly be a tough game to win, followed by Atlanta and a bye week. Entering the bye week 4-0 will be a big challenge, but it's definitely not out of the question. Slowing this offense down when it's clicking the way it has will present problems for even the league's best defense. Now, just playing devil's advocate here, they put up 43 on a Vikings defense that looks absolutely abysmal so far, and a Lions defense coached by Matt Patricia. This could be an overreaction, but with a combination of Rodgers playing like the Rodgers from 10 years ago, and him finally having a running game, I don't think it is. And because of that, the NFC could very well run through Green Bay. And while we are in the NFC North, we might as well go to another team. The Minnesota Vikings are, and as much as this pains me to say through just 2 weeks of the year, but done. I do want to say I sincerely hope I am wrong on this, but in the very rare case, the Vikings have given their fans almost nothing to cheer for through two games. The defense is offensive to the word Swiss cheese defense, as they can't stop anybody, and the offense was almost nothing against the Colts. Quarterback Kirk Cousins finished Sunday 11 for 26 with 113 yards and 3 interceptions, and while one of those interceptions were from a Hail Mary, he nor anyone really looked good on Sunday. Irv Smith and Kyle Rudolph, who were expected to play much bigger roles this year, combined for 5 targets, which resulted in 1 catch for 3 yards. The Colts held the ball for 37 minutes in Week 2, and the Packers held the ball for 42 minutes in Week 1. The concerns about the young corners have more than proven to be true, but perhaps what is most concerning is the pass rush from the defensive line, or should I say, lack of. Yes, Yannick had a sack on Sunday, but time and time again, Aaron Rodgers and Phillip Rivers had all day to throw the football and pick the defense apart. Not only that, but in bad teams, a lot of the time you see players energetic when they make big plays, are genuinely hyped for another, but it seems like this team is just lull and going through the motions. I am officially going on record saying it's time to get Zimmer out as coach, as let's be honest here, whether you want to accept this as a Vikings fan, they have reached their peak with him. It's time to start over with a new coach, and as painful as this sounds, more than likely start over with a new quarterback as well. They have played with absolutely no fire in them through the first 2 weeks, and it has more than showed. A former player that was traded this offseason is probably laughing at how their season is going, and that of course is Bills receiver Stefon Diggs. And with Stefon's quarterback being the thumbnail of today's video, we now head to Buffalo for the next part of the video. And the next takeaway is Josh Allen is elite. Through 2 weeks of the NFL, he is playing out of his mind, and is currently on pace for over 5,800 passing yards, 42 touchdowns, and most importantly to Bills fans, 16 wins. What was most concerning for Josh heading into 2020 was certainly his accuracy. Could he consistently make completions, and could he lead the Bills down the stretch if he needs to? Through two games, the answer to both, without a doubt, yes. September is a prime time for overreactions, but with the younger quarterbacks taking over the NFL, like Pat, Lamar, and not that he's in the same tier as them, but now Josh Allen, the Bills could be a major thorn in the sides of the Chiefs and the Ravens. We know how good these teams are and how much respect they get around the league, and rightfully so, but Buffalo as the 3 seed in the AFC could cause either of these teams major problems in the playoffs. The acquisition of Stefon Diggs has proven to be a great addition so far, as the Bills have hit their stride seamlessly to start the year, while the team they traded with looks like a dumpster fire. I did say the AFC runs through Baltimore at the beginning of this video, and I do believe that, but the Bills certainly should not be slept on. We had Brady and Manning in the 2000s, and it would be very fun in the 20s if we had Mahomes, Allen, Jackson, and Watson, and as of now, it looks to be very possible. Josh Allen is taking the next step as a player, and by season's end, could be considered an elite quarterback. And the next takeaway is that Seattle and Green Bay may meet in the playoffs again. Seattle beat New England in a very good, very fun game to watch on Sunday night, and Russell Wilson looked like one of the best players in football, which of course, he is. Through 2 weeks, he has 11 incompletions, 9 passing touchdowns, and most importantly, 2 wins. Seattle will need to get their defense under control, as in back-to-back weeks, they have now given up 55 points, but when Seattle is putting up 35 to 38 a game, it doesn't really matter. As good as Russell has been, there will be a game or two this year where he can't put up 35 points, but as of now, the Seahawks are looking poised to make another Super Bowl run. Their next 3 games are home against Dallas, at Miami, and home against Minnesota, which all are winnable. This team could start out 5-0, and even if they do lose to Dallas, they will beat Miami, and there's no words to describe how bad they will beat Minnesota on primetime TV in Week 5. DK Metcalf will be one of the best receivers in football soon enough, and very well could make a case that he already is. He has 2 90-yard games in 2 weeks, and I would imagine there is certainly more to come. Matt Ryan threw for nearly 300 yards and 4 touchdowns against Dallas, which, as we said, Seattle plays next week, and I do think Russell Wilson is better than Matt Ryan. Seattle will be a dangerous team down the stretch, and we could have a rematch of the 2014 NFC Championship game, which of course was Green Bay at Seattle. And the next quick point before we wrap up, is Dallas showed the hype yesterday was real, as they came back from down 20 against Atlanta, sorry Chris, and in the process, Dak threw for nearly 500 yards and had 4 total touchdowns. They will probably start out 1-2 2, but the good news for them is I honestly think 7 or 8 wins takes the NFC East this year. Two last thoughts for Week 2, Adam Gase and Matt Patricia should both be fired, as it's clear neither the Jets nor Lions will ever win anything substantial with those guys leading them, so I do think it's better to just cut ties sooner rather than later. And with that being said, that's all I have for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. If you ever have a video suggestion, please let me know. I truly appreciate all the support, and I will see you guys next time. Have a great day.